So many people used to ask me in the comment session, or they even in our Telegram group, people ask what is the benefit of trading in corporate accounts. So if you are following any famous YouTubers, you can see they are showing their P&L in corporate account. Of course, there are some tax benefit when you trade in corporate account. We also have a corporate account. We have a LLP, limited liable partnership. We have a fintech LLP. Registered in Ministry of Commerce, ROC Chennai, and we are actively trading in that account. Of course, I have not shown that account till now because of obvious reasons, but when time permits, I will also show how much we make in our corporate account. So why do we have to trade in corporate account, or what are the benefits are in trading in corporate account? Of course, there are things you can do in corporate accounts. See, I'm not going to tell outright, but I will tell you in a way you have to understand. So I will tell you, but you have to think of itself and you have to understand. I'm not going to tell you outright what is going to be the benefit or advantages of disadvantages when it comes to trading in a corporate account. I will say you understand, if you see if you can understand the concept, right? So literally, say for example, if you want to trade in a corporate account and you want to, you are trading a big fund, let's say you are trading 5 crores or 10 crores, you need a corporate account to trade your account. You can do in individual trading account also, but your tax is going to be heavy. So when it comes to corporate account, there are 3 ways to opening a corporate account. First one is, which is called private limited company, and second one is called OPC, and the third one is called LLP. So private limited company, you know, that is a normal private limited company, or if it is listed, it is called a public limited company. OPC means one person company, and LLP means limited liable partnership. So LLP formation was formulated in 2008, and since then it has been very famous, and it is very you don't have any regulatory hurdles when it comes to LLP. So forming an LLP or winding up an LLP is very easy when you compare it with incorporating a private limited or OPC company. Now income tax slab is 30% for private limited, and one person company is also 30%, and LLP is also 30%. And there is an additional surcharge when you do it in a corporate account. 7% is the surcharge when your total annual income is less than 10 crores, and when it exceeds 10 crore, it is going to be 12% for private limited company. And applies to OPC also, one person company. When your income is less than 10 crore per annum, it is going to be 7%, and it is going to be 12% when you exceed 10 crores in total annual income. And for LLP, it is 12% if you exceed 1 crore in annual income. And it is taxed as private limited is taxed as domestic company. OPC, one person company, is also taxed as domestic company, and LLP is taxed as a partnership firm. And salaries to directors, like let us say for example, if you are forming a private limited company, you have to have at least 2 directors. Maybe you are one director, you are your family member is another director, so at least it has to have 2%, 2 directors, minimum of 2 directors in any private limited company. And same applies to LLP also. When you form a LLP, at least 2 members have to be directors. And when it comes to private limited company, number of shareholders can be from 2 to 200, but in LLP it can be maximum, no problem. Even 1,000 shareholders or 1,500 shareholders or any number of shareholders can be partners in LLP. But when it comes to private limited company, only 2 peoples can be partners. And interest and remuneration is taxable income, and in private limited company, one person company is also taxable income, and in LLP it is allowed as a deduction. So what does that mean? I will tell you in a few minutes. And tax burden is also moderate in private limited and OPC, and LLP tax rate is very low when you compare it to private limited and 1% company. So that is why we are behind formation, LLP, formation of LLP. Now there are various other reasons also to form a LLP company when it comes to trading. Now let us take my example. Now we have various income. We have trading income, we have training income, we have sponsorship income, we have some other incomes also, right? Now we will all divert this income to, let us say, we will not divert to my personal account or my personal entity names. We will transfer, we will do all the transaction in our company account so that our accounts are audited and we can do the taxation every year. We can do the auditing every year, right? Now, the taxation part is one thing. You will get the tax benefit. You just ask your auditor, like, what is the benefit of forming an LLP or a private limited for trading? I don't want to say anything in social media, but you can, if you can ask your broker how to open a corporate account, you can open a corporate account with your stock broker. So he is going to tell you how to open a corporate account with your broker. Now the first benefit is tax part, and the second benefit is, let us say you are having family members, or you want funds, extra funds, okay? Let us say you are having 10 lakhs and your friend is having 15 lakhs and your brother is having 5 lakhs, your mother-in-law is having around 10 lakh or 15 lakhs. Now you have to fund your resources, or let us say you are having a friend, big friend range, or you are having, you know, many people, your connections are good, and you want to pool all the funds to one place so that you can trade with that funds, right? So what you do, you cannot go and pitch with your individual name. See, I cannot go and say, I am Umar, I am trading, I can do this, that, this. It is not going to work that way. You have to approach, or you have to pitch in a professional way. To attain this professional ethics, or to attain a professional status, you have to form a company. You need to have a company formation so that when you pitch to your clients, or when you pitch to your customers, or when you pitch to your friends, family friends, you will get a decent, you will have a decent exposure, or you will have a decent look. So that is one reason, plus also the tax benefit. And the third reason is also, see, we run an office, we can put all the charges, all the expenses in our trading company account. I have a car, I refill the car, I will put in company account. I go to tea, I have some tea, I will put in company account. I go to lunch with my family, I go to dinner with my family, I put it in a company account. So every bill I collect and I will give to accounts, and they will put it in our. So no matter what, you pay electricity bill, you pay rental charges, you pay DTH charges, you pay telephone charges, whatever payment you do, we will put everything in our company account. So that way we will try to, you know, right? So I don't want to say anything outright. You have to understand how things work here. So this is just a small video, or this is just a small brief about company account. And also there is another thing, if you are not earning more than 25 lakhs or 30 lakhs per annum, I wouldn't recommend anyone to go for a corporate account. If your annual income is less than 25 or 30 lakhs, it is better to do auditing in your name. If your income exceeds more than 25 or 30 lakhs, then it is advisable for you to go for a corporate account, right? So I have explained as much as I could. So hope you understand. Thank you for watching. Take care. Bye.